Hello students, today we will discuss about the module 3 of WC and LTE 4G broadband subject. In this, today we discuss about the part B of the module 3, that is the downlink transport channel processing. Myself Prabha K, assistant professor, SVIT Bangalore. Contents of this part are downlink transport channel processing overview, downlink shared channels, downlink control channels, broadcast and multicast channels, downlink physical channels, and HARQ in the downlink. In the last session, we have discussed about the downlink transport channel processing, which mainly includes the two processes, channel coding process and the modulation process. So today we'll continue with the modulation processing. In this subsection, we discuss about the generic modulation procedures which have been followed and which will be applicable to more than one physical channel type. The modulation takes in one or two code words depending upon whether the spatial multiplexing is used and converts them into complex valued OFDM baseband signals from each antenna port. The modulation processing mainly consists of scrambling, modulation mapping, MIMO related multi antenna processing, resource mapping, and OFDM signal generation. First one, scrambling. Scrambling is a digital encoding technique that is used in modern data communication schemes and can principally provide aid in retrieving information from received data, enhancing synchronization between the transmitter and the receiver. Before modulation, the code word generated through the channel coding processing is first scrambled by a bit level scrambling sequence. It is scrambling code. By using this scrambling code, E-node can separate the signals coming simultaneously from many different user equipments, and user equipment can separate signal coming simultaneously from different E-nodes. A specific bit sequence which is used for the scrambling, we call it as a scrambling code. Except in multicast channel, for all other downlink transport channels and control information, the scrambling sequence are different for neighboring cells so that inter-cell interference can be reduced. This slide gives you a brief information about how actually scrambling process is carried out. The different datas are transmitted with a different bit rate. There will be a channelization. After channelization, the multiplexing will take place. After multiplexing, a scrambling process will be carried out, generating a scrambling code. Based on the chip rate, it will be transmitted to the RF modulator. Then it will be float into the air. Modulation mapping. Each code word Q, the block of scrambled bit is given by BQ of 0 up to BQ of MB minus 1. The modulated, which are modulated into a block of complex valued modulation symbols, which is given by DQ of 0, DQ up to DQ of 1, up to DQ of MS minus 1, where MS of Q is the number of modulation symbols in each code word and depends upon the modulation scheme. The relation between the MSQ and the MBQ is as follows. The MSQ is equal to MBQ, MB to the power of Q divided by QM. Layer mapping and the precoding. Both layer mapping and the precoding are associated with a multi-antenna transmission and reception, the basis of which can be found split into two types. Two steps allows the inclusion of all antenna processing schemes in a single framework. These two steps map the incoming code words to up to four transmit antennas, which will be illustrated in the next figure. The layer mapper maps the NC codes into V spatial layers, while the precoder maps the V layers to a P antenna ports. And all these maximum technologies are used in the MIMO transmissions. You can make out here the layer mapping and the precoding. The number of NC code words are coming is the layer mapped, and then it will be allotted to the V layers. The pre-coding will allot these V layer bits into the different antenna ports. Now we'll discuss about different terminologies used in this technology. Code word. A code word is defined as an output of each channel coding or rate matching stage associated with single transport block coming from the MAC layer. For MIMO transmission with the multiple code words and different spatial channels, more efficient detectors with a successive interference cancellation can be used. In LTE technology, although up to 4 transmitter receive antennas are supported, the number of code words is limited to only 2. This is to limit the uplink feedback overhead, as separate HARQ process is operated for each code word, which requires separate signaling in the uplink control channel. Hence, the total code words is limited for 2 in LTE technology. Layer. A layer corresponds to a data stream of spatial multiplexing channel. Each code word is mapped into one or multiple layers. Therefore, the number of layers, which is essentially the transmission rank, is at least as many as the number of code words. That is, V should be greater than or equal to NC. That is the number of code words. Well, V is the number of layers. Antenna port is defined by its associated reference signal, which is a logical entity and may not correspond to any actual physical antenna. The number of transmit antenna ports at the E node is sent to UVs through a PBCH channel, which can be either 1, 2 or 4 in LTE. The antenna ports are divided into 3 groups. Antenna ports 0 to 3 are cell specific, which are used for downlink MIMO transmission. The antenna port 4 is for multicast or broadcast single frequency network specific, and it is used for MBSFN transmission. Antenna port 5 is user equipment specific, which is used for the beam forming to a single user equipment using all physical antennas. Coming to the next topic, downlink shared channels. As we described, the physical layer is a processing for specific transport channels, including the downlink shared channel, the downlink control channel, the broadcast channel, and the multicast channel. Although most of the transport channels implement the various aspects of transport channel processing, such as the channel coding, rate matching, symbol mapping, MIMO processing, and OFDM modulation, the specific of each step vary from one transport channel to the other. The downlink shared channel is carried on a physical downlink shared channel. Data transmission in the PDSCH is based on the concept of shared channel transmission, where the physical layer resources that uses the resource blocks which is available for PDSCH is treated as a common resource that can be dynamically shared among different user equipments. The dynamic multiplexing of user equipments on a PDSCH is done by the scheduler on a 1 millisecond interval. This way, a large portion of radio resource can be allocated to a specific user equipment which is suitable for packet data applications. In addition to this, with a shared channel transmission and the opportunistic scheduling, multi-user diversity can be obtained in LTE technology. This diagram shows you the channel mapping around the downlink shared channel, which is already analyzed in the previous portion of the module 3. The channel mapping around the downlink shared channel is shown here. You can see that the downlink shared channels carry both traffic and the control data from the logical channels, and the paged channel was also carried on this PDSCH. In this section, we can analyze an introduction about the channel coding and the modulation of the DLSCH, and also the different supported MIMO transmission. Channel encoding and modulation. The downlink shared channel uses the rate of 1/3 convolution turbo code. The rate matching is used in order to achieve an effective channel coding rate that matches the payload capacity determined by the number of resource blocks allocated to the transport block of a given user equipment and the modulation scheme. The redundancy version used for the repetition or puncturing depends on the HARQ transmission number, and it is indicated explicitly in E note. The moderation scheme is allowed for the DLSSCH includes UPSK 16 QAM or 64 QAM and is chosen based on the channel quality indicator provided by the user equipment and the various other parameters such as the size of the transport block. The transport block size is the redundancy version and the modulation order are indicated in the downlink control information, that is DCI. For MIMO spatial multiplexing with the two code words, different modulation and the coding can be used for each code word, which requires individual signaling. The resource mapping of the PDSSCH physical channel depends upon whether the user equipment specific reference signals are transmitted. Multi-antenna transmission. As the main channel for downlink traffic data transmission, the PDSSCH supports all the MIMO codes specified in the LTE, which makes this subsection an appropriate place to describe the transmission of various MIMO modes. There are seven different transmission modes defined for data transmission in PDSSCH, physical downlink shared channel for LTE technology. Single antenna port, which we call it as a port zero, one transport block is transmitted from the single physical antenna corresponding to antenna port zero. Transmit diversity, one transport block is transmitted from more than one physical antenna, that is port zero and one, if two physical antennas are used, and port zero, one, two, and three, if four physical antennas are used. Open loop spatial multiplexing technology is used in this. One or two transport blocks are transmitted from two or four physical antennas. In this case, the predefined precoder matrices are used based on the rank indicator feedback, and this precoding matrix is fixed and not adopted. Closed loop spatial multiplexing is used where one or two transport blocks are transmitted from two or four physical antennas. The precoding in this case is adopted based on precoding matrix indicator PMI feedback from the user equipment. Multi-user MIMO. In this, two user equipments are multiplexed on two or four physical antennas with one transport block to each user equipment. The rank one PMI feedback from each UE is used to create the overall precoding matrix. Closed loop rank one precoding. It is a special case of closed loop spatial multiplexing with a single layer transmission, that is P into one precoder is applied for this technique. Single antenna port always we use as a port 5. A single transport block is transmitted from two or more physical antennas. The E-node performs the beam forming to a single user equipment using all physical antennas. Unlike other modes, in this case, the reference signal is also transmitted using the same beamforming vector that is used for the data symbols. Thus, in this mode, the beamforming technique is used at the E-node is transparent to the user equipment, and the user equipment is able to decode the transport block with the help of this user's equipment specific reference signal. Beamforming can be used to improve the received signal power and reduce the interference signal power, which is especially important for cell edge user. Now we'll move on to the downlink shared channels. Downlink control channels. Downlink control channels are carried over the physical downlink control channel, PDCCH, physical downlink control channel. They contain control information from the MAC layer, including DCI, CFI, HI. DCI means downlink control information. CFI is a control format indicator. HI is HARQ indicator. Channel mapping between the control information and the physical channel is shown in this. There are a specific physical channel for each type of control information. On the physical layer, the physical downlink control channel and the physical downlink shared channels are time multiplexed such that PDCCH is carried over the first few OFDM symbols of each subframe and PDSSCH is carried over the rest of the OFDM symbols. The number of OFDM symbols allocated for PDCCH can vary from 1 to 4 and it is conveyed by the CFI. The CFI is carried on at another control channel known as a physical control channel format indicator channels, PCFICH, which is always carried in a predetermined format over the first OFDM symbol of each subframe. This predetermined format of PCFICH, that is physical control format indicator channel, allows each user equipment to decode the CFI without any problems or without any ambiguity, and thus determine the number of OFDM symbols in the beginning of each subframe that are used as a control region. Downlink control information DCI formats that we already studied. There are different type of DCI formats are there. Just have a look into these different formats of DCI. Among the control information and the downlink, the DCI is the most important and it carries the detailed control information for both downlink and uplink transmission. Therefore, in this section, we first analyze what are the different DCI formats. The DCI carries the downlink scheduling assignments, uplink scheduling grants, power control commands, and other information necessary for the scheduled user equipments to decode and demodulate the data symbols in the downlink or encode and modulate the data symbols in the uplink process. LTE defines the 10 different DCI formats for different transmission scenarios summarized as follows. DCI format 0, which carries the uplink scheduling grants and necessary control information for uplink transmission. DCI format 1A, 1B, 1C, 1D provides scheduling information for one code word transmission without spatial multiplexing. This category has the largest number of types in order to save the signaling resources on the PDCCH, as these formats are optimized for specific use cases and transmission modes. DCI formats 2 and 2A provide the downlink scheduling information for CL and OL, closed loop and the open loop spatial multiplexing respectively. In this case, the DCI contains the information about the modulation and coding scheme and the redundancy version for each of the two code words. DCI formats 3 and 3A carry the transmit power control, which is in short we call it as TPC, transmit power control commands for uplink process. This gives you a fields of DCI format 0. This is the information type, number of bits used, and the purpose. This gives the fields of DCI format 1. Same, what are the information which will be carried in this format, number of bits used to carry the information, and what purpose it is used. How these informations are encoded and modulated. For a downlink control information, that is a DCI, which is always mapped to the PDCCH physical channel, and the multiple PDCCH can be transmitted in a one subframe. A 16-bit CRC is attached to the control information symbols. The CRC parity bits are then scrambled according to the following rules. What are the rules? There are two rules. If the user equipment transmit the antenna selection is not configured or applicable, the CRC parity bits are scrambled with one radio network temporary identifier. Radio network temporary identifier, which is the user equipment identity, then the user equipment is able to detect its own DCI. If user equipment transmit antenna selection is configured and applicable, the CRC parity bits of the PDCCH with the DCI format 0 are scrambled with the corresponding radio network temporary identifier and the antenna selection mask, which informs the user equipment about the selected antenna port. Control format indicator indicates the how many OFDM symbols and the DCI spans in the subframe. Such an indicator is needed because the load on PDCCH varies depending upon the number of resource blocks and signaling formats conveyed in the physical downlink control channel. HARQ indicator, that is HI. This is a control information for HARQ acknowledgement in response to the uplink transmission. As spatial multiplexing is not supported in uplink in the current specifications, only one information bit is required for HARQ acknowledgement. If HI value is 1, indicating for the positive acknowledgement. If this is 0, it indicates the negative acknowledgement. HI is mapped to the PHI-CH physical channel. Multiple PHI-CH mapped to the same set of resource elements constitute a PCI-CH group, where the PCI-CH within the same group are separated through the different orthogonal sequences with a spreading factor of 4. Coming to the next important topic, broadcast channels. Broadcast channels carry system information such as a downlink system bandwidth, antenna configuration, and the reference signal power. The user equipment can get the necessary system information after cell search procedure. Due to the large size of the system information field, it is divided into two portions: master information block transmitted on the PDCH and the system information block transmitted on PDSCH. The PBCH contains the basic and system parameters necessary to demodulate the PDSCH, which contains the remaining SIB, that is the system information blocks. The transmission of PBCH is characterized by fixed predetermined transport format and resource allocation, that is, there is no higher layer control. Error detection is provided through the 16-bit CRC, then the CRC parity bits are scrambled according to the E-node transmit antenna configuration, which is scrambling sequence specified. This implicitly tells the user equipment about the E-node antenna configuration. The tail bitting convolution coding with a rate of 1/3 is used, and the coded bits are rate matched with to the 1920 bits of the normal CP with the and to 1728 bits for the extended CP. These are the parameters which is considered in a broadcast channel. Along with that, there are two modulation the scheme is used. One is the QPSK with the HARQ not supporting. For MIMO modes, PBCH supports a single antenna transmission and open loop transmit diversity. Dynamic adaptation modulation in the coding is not possible due to the lack of channel quality feedback. The complex valued modulation symbols are mapped onto 72 subcarriers centered around DC subcarrier in slot 1 in the subframe 0. During the 4 consecutive radio frames, that is the transmission time interval, that is a TTI, for the PBCH is around 40 milliseconds. The PBCH occupies the most narrow bandwidth supported by the LTE, which is the 1.4 megahertz, and it is allocated in the subframe guaranteed to be used in the downlink. Therefore, the resource mapping of the PBCH is independent of the system bandwidth and the duplex mode. This allows the user equipment to detect and decode the PBCH without any prior knowledge of the system bandwidth and the duplex mode. Once the PBCH is detected and the MIB is decoded, the user equipment can extract the system bandwidth and duplex mode. Now we'll discuss about the multicast channels. Multimedia broadcast and the multicast services MBMS introduced in the GPP release of the version 4 in the which is used for the UTRA version 2, supporting the multicast and the broadcast services in the cellular system. It sends the same content information to all the user equipment, that is the broadcast, or to a given set of UEs, that is a multicast, and it is envisaged for delivering the services such as mobile TV. In principle, the MBMS transmission can originate from the single base station or multiple base station. But multi-cell transmission is preferred as a large gains can be achieved through the soft combining of transmission from multiple base stations. For MBMS in UTRA technique, to receive the same data information from the multiple cell, the complexity of the receiver is high and there will be an interference between the signal from the different base stations. One major design requirement for the LTE is to provide the enhanced support for the MBMS transmission, which is called as enhanced MBMS, and it is achieved through the so-called technology called as single frequency network operation. With the OFDM based transmission in the downlink over the air, combining the multicast or a broadcast transmission from the multiple base station, it is possible in the LTE with an extended CP. The extended CP is used in the propagation delay for multiple cells and will typically be larger than the delay spread in the single cell. A longer CP can ensure that the signals from the different base stations still fall with the CP at the receiver, which avoids the inter-symbol interference at the cost of slight reduction in peak data rate. Essentially, it makes synchronous multi-cell, multicast, broadcast transmission appears as a single transmission over the multipath channel. And since the OFDM is efficient in combating the multipath channels, there is a no resulting interference. In such a multicast or broadcast single frequency network, the same information is broadcast on the same radio resource from the multiple synchronized neighboring base stations to multiple user equipments. The single frequency network operation has already been used in the terrestrial digital video broadcasting system. Downlink physical signals. In this section, we describe about the structure and processing of a downlink physical signals, including the downlink reference signal and the synchronization signal. The emphasis is on the resource mapping of different signals. Downlink reference signals. Downlink reference signal consists of known reference symbols that are intended for downlink channel estimation at the user equipment needed to perform coherent demodulation. To facilitate the channel estimation process, scattered reference signals are inserted in the resource grid at predetermined intervals. The time and the frequency interval are mainly determined by the characteristics of the channel and should make a trade-off between the estimation accuracy and the overhead. There are three different types of downlink reference signal: cell-specific reference signal, MBSFN reference signal, user equipment specific reference signal. The reference sequence is generated from a pseudo random sequence with a different initializations for different types of reference signal. There is one reference signal transmitted per downlink antenna port. For MBSFN reference signal, identical sequence is transmitted from cells involved in the MBSFN transmission, while cell-specific sequence are used for other types of reference signals. In this subsection, we analyze how various reference signals are mapped to the physical layer resource elements. Cell-specific reference signals are transmitted in all downlink subframes in a cell supporting non-MBSFN transmission. In the subframe used for the transmission with the MBSFN, only the first two OFDM symbol can be used for the cell-specific reference symbols. Cell-specific reference signals are defined separately for antenna port 0, 1, 2, and 3, which is shown in the next slide. Therefore, in LTE, a maximum of 4 antenna can be used while transmitting the cell-specific reference signal. The cell-specific reference signals are defined only for the normal subcarrier spacing of delta F is equal to 15 kilohertz. This diagram gives you an example of mapping the downlink cell-specific reference signal with the 4 antenna ports. This is for port 0, port 1, port 2, and port 3. And with the normal CP, RF denotes the resource elements which are used for the reference signal transmission on the antenna port. Here, the whatever the RO is there indicates the resource. The RER resource elements are used for the reference signal. RO related to port 0 or port 0, R1 for port 1, R2 for a port 2, R3 for a port 3. These are the resource elements used for the reference signal transmission in the respective port. MBSFN reference signals are only transmitted in subframes allocated for MBSFN transmission, which is only defined by the extended CP and transmitted on the antenna port 4. In the time domain for even numbered slots, the reference symbols are inserted in the third OFDM symbol with the frequency of 15 kHz and the second OFDM signal for with the 7.5 kHz. For odd numbered slots, the reference symbols are inserted in the first and fifth OFDM symbols with the 15 kHz in the first and the third OFDM symbol for a 7.5 kHz. So depending upon the even number slots or odd number slots, at the particular frequency, these reference symbols are inserted. In the frequency domain, the reference symbols are transmitted every two subcarriers for delta f is equal to 15 kHz and every four subcarriers with a delta f is equal to 7.5 kHz. The reference symbols are transmitted from the second and the third subcarrier will be 15 kHz and 7.5 kHz respectively. Otherwise, it will always start with the first subcarrier. Based on this rule, the MBSFN reference signals are mapped with the resources. With the extended CP and the delta f is equal to 15 kHz, the density of the MBSFN reference signal in the frequency domain will be 3 times higher than that of the cell-specific reference signal. This is because of single frequency network transmission includes a highly specific, highly frequency selective channel, so it requires a high density reference signals in the frequency domain. This gives you an example of mapping of MBSFN reference signal with the extended CP and delta f is equal to 15 kHz. As we know already, MBSFN reference signals are always attached to the antenna port 4. Wherever the R4 is, that is the reference signal indication. You can make out here for even numbered, it will be for slot 3. And for the odd number, it is for slot 0 and slot 5. User equipment, specific reference signals support single antenna port transmission with a beam forming for the physical downlink shade channels and transmitted on antenna port 5. They are transmitted only on the resource block upon which the corresponding physical downlink shade channel is mapped. The user equipment specific signal is not transmitted in resource elements in which the one of the other physical signals or other channels are transmitted. An example of a resource mapping of user specific channels is shown in the next diagram. With the normal CP, the even numbered slots, the reference symbols are inserted in the fourth and seventh OFDM symbols. For odd number slots, the reference signals are inserted at the third and sixth OFDM symbols. There is a frequency shift in two subcarriers in the neighboring reference symbols. You can make out here for an even numbered, it is for the slot 4 and slot 7. Whereas for an odd number, it is slot 3 and slot 6. And it is slot 2 and slot 5. Because these slots are numbered as 0 to 6 for odd number, these reference signals will be attached to the antenna port. For odd number, it will be slot 2 and slot 5. For even number, it will be slot 4 and slot 7. Slot 3 and slot 6. HARQ in the downlink. In a wireless network, due to the effects of channel fading and interference from neighboring cell, it is nearly impossible to guarantee an error-free transmission no matter how robust the channel coding is used. Moreover, as the coding rate decreases, the transmission becomes more robust, but at the same time, power efficiency also lost. That is, the significant amount of power is used to transmit a few bits of information. An elegant approach to solve this problem is to use the HARQ protocol, which combines FEC, forward error correction, and the retransmission within the single framework. In the case of LTE, both type 1 chase combining CC HARQ and type 2 incremental redundancy IR HARQ schemes have been defined. The HARQ operation is a part of the MAC layer, while the physical layer handles the soft combining. The 1x3 turbo coding is used as the forward error correction code, while the CRC is supplied for the error detection. At the receiver, we can make out that the turbo decoding is first applied on the received code block. If this is a retransmission, which is indicated in the DCI format, the code block will be combined with the previously received versions of the for decoding purpose. If there is no error detected in the output of the decoder, an acknowledgement signal is fed back to the transmitter through the PUCCH physical uplink control channel, that is a physical channel, and decoded block is passed to the upper layer, otherwise not acknowledgement, NA key. Signal is fed back and the received code block is stored in the buffer for subsequent combining. At the receiver, for each retransmission, the same turbo encoded data is transmitted with a different puncturing. So each of these retransmission has a different redundancy version and each is self-decodable. Puncturing is performed during the rate matching process. The rate matcher can produce the four different redundancy versions of the original block which has been coded. This is about the module 3 part B. Thank you.